Hallelujah. I thank you, Lord. God is so good. Yeah, God has been so good to me. God is good for you. Worthy is the Lamb, worthy is the Lamb of God who was slain to receive power. And wealth and wisdom, strength and honor, glory, praise. Oh yes, we need power, wealth, wisdom, strength. It's Jesus, Lamb of God, had all those things. So if we pray, God going to give to you that you want. Except three things. That is honor, praise, glory. That is going to the Lamb of God. Okay, I'm going to preaching, continue to end times in the prophecy in Book of Revelation. I'm going to start at the moment John had wept. He wept and wept because he could not find the one who is able to break the seal and open the scroll. One of the elders said, here is a, oh, honey, listen to me. Here is and the lion of a tribe of Judah. Oh, hallelujah, praise. And the root of David. So listen, that is a phenomenon. All creatures, all heaven and earth, even the sea, on the sea, pray the Lord. Oh, hallelujah. When Lamb of God got the scroll to break the seal, you know, Jesus gave the meaning of the seals in the Olivet prophecy about the end time. That is a parallel and we found the in Matthew 24, Mark 13, Luke 21. The fourth seal represents the widespread deception by false Christianity that began in days of apostle time to our time. The verse 24-5. It is white horse. Second seal refer to increasing chaos, devastation, and disaster. And called by war, you know. At the end approaches, we had the share word of God concerning the four seals before. So I am not going to and speak and more and the word of these four seals now. So I just and talking about the outline of these the first four seals and in Revelation 6th chapter. Okay, third seal it represents increasing and the hunger and the famine, and it is black horse. You know, let me tell you some the world. I want to tell you something that what is the main reason in fighting in countries? What is the main factor to break out and to leading the last war, Armageddon? Here is the scripture I want you to know. This is all about oil, black gold, oil. You know that? Oil. Oil is its problem now. Isaiah 34:9 already Isaiah prophesied about the oil. Really, what? You know, middle country nation is in a major that oil country in the world, like Saudi Arabia, Iran, and Iran, and Syria. So this scripture, listen. Edom's stream will be turned into the pitch. Her dust and into burning sulfur. Her land, you know, and the will become and blazing pitch. You know the pitch. Pitch is material of making asphalt. And this pitch is a material to to making in the crude oil. So this the pitch that will be burned whole days. It will never quench, and its smoke will rise forever. This is Isaiah 34:10. So you can see in the Middle East now that this the light, the burning pitch will be blazed and forever, never stop. Okay. That is now this in Middle East and lot of and almost the Middle East country produced the oil. That's why the country is fighting for this oil. Okay, I'm going to move the next seal, and other consequences of war and famine are represented by the fourth seal. This thing as a disease, plague, and civil unrest, we see every day. The Bible say, nation against nation, and tribe against the tribe, that is civil war, that killed many people. Now, look at the Syria civil war, Iraq civil war. They are fighting each other. Bible already prophesied. It is a pale horse. All of this event in the first four series have been occurring with varying frequency and intensity from Christ's time to our days. But listen, brother and sister, that is we should know and the trend that going to happen in the last day. They have greatly intensified over the last century, the 20th century, and will grow even worse, and suffering mankind will have to endure near the end. Bible say it passing all things getting worse and worse. Not it's going to is good, we are going to is the right way. No. It's getting bad. It's worse and worse near the, in the future. So, fifth seal was opened. And he was opened and listened. Paul saw strange scene and on the altar. Many, many people who had died for the word of God, for the kingdom of God, died. He saw also, listen, that is boys still touch my air. I believe touch your air too, if we Christian. This matters boys. They said, oh Lord, how long we have to wait until your revenge, the true God, the justice, and you will revenge for our blood. They were told by the Lord. The answer in that time of God's judgment on oppression will not come until the number of the martyrs is filled up. That God said, wait until another martyr will come out in the end time. I will say in 666 times. It's coming soon. There is to be an end time martyrdom that must yet take place. Okay, I'm going to move next seal. When the sixth seal is opened, oh, I'm going to hurry up, make a fast, and follow me. I'm still here with me. John sees dramatic signs in heaven. You know, he describes the great meteor showers, so intense that it appears that the very stars feel falling out of the sky. You know, like resembling eclipse. You know, the sun eclipse and the solar eclipse and the moon and eclipse. Is the God's judgment to the universal scope? This dramatic and frightening event is accompanied massive earthquake. Okay, so you know, is only one judgment left. It's a trumpet judgment. The seventh seal consists of these seven trumpets. So what exactly happens when the seventh and the final trumpet blast is sounded? So I want to make a conclusion of this book of Revelation as of my sermon today. Revelation 11:15 say that is tremendously in the seal by our Lord. Listen, my brother and sister. Kingdom of the world have become the kingdom of our Lord and of His Christ. Oh, hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Are you still with me? And He shall reign forever and ever. Oh, hallelujah. Praise the Lord. His kingdom, His sovereignty, His power is going about to happen when last trumpet sounded. The book of Revelation tells us the end of the history and the beginning of the forever. Himself standing upon the very brink of eternity where we are looking for, with assurance that Jesus Christ dearly will return soon. Yes, He'll come soon. Oh, hallelujah. Praise the Lord. And I want to tell you one scripture. It helps you keep in mind this book of Revelation. Blessed those who read and hear the word of God, this prophecy. Keep in your mind. Hallelujah. I will see next week. Thank you, Lord Jesus Christ, our Lord.